हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद सेल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ कारा। नोडल सेल्स ऑफ कारा आर यूनिन्यूक्लिएट एंड डेंसली साइटोप्लाज्मिक विद फ्यू स्मॉल एलिप्सॉइडल क्लोरोप्लास्ट्स। इंटरनोडल सेल्स आर एलोंगेटेड विद अ लार्ज सेंट्रल वैक्यूल एंड मैनी न्यूक्लियाई एंड इन्यूमरेबल डिस्कॉइड क्लोरोप्लास्ट्स which are lack of pyrenoids. Internodal cells and cytoplasm of internodal cells divided into inner endoplasm which lies next to vacuole and an outer ectoplasm having chloroplasts. And cytoplasmic streaming occur in endoplasm along longitudinal plane. Cytoplasmic streaming is due to alternating contraction and expansion of protein fibrils which remain fixed to the cell wall. Now come to the growth of Kara. In Kara, growth of main axis and its branches occur by a dome shaped apical cell. Transverse divisions of apical cell produce a row of disc-shaped cells. Each divides transversely and form upper biconcave nodal initial and lower biconcave internodal initial. So upper one is biconcave nodal and lower one is biconvex internodal. So these are the initials. As a result of many vertical divisions at right angles to each other in nodal initial, a pair of central cells and many peripheral cells are formed. The peripheral cells act as mother cell for primary laterals and behave in the same manner as apical cells. The peripheral cells of basal node form rhizoids and internodal initials does not divide further but elongates considerably. Now talking about reproduction, so Kara reproduces by two means mode of reproduction, that are vegetative method and second one is sexual method. First of all, we are going to talk about vegetative reproduction, in which we studied about amylum stars. So in this topic, basal nodal cells develop in a peculiar fashion and form star shaped aggregations of cells which are densely filled by amylum starch. When detached from the parent plant, these bodies develop into new plant. So Kara can be reproduced by using amylum stars vegetatively. And then next point is root bulbil. Kara also can reproduce through vegetative mode of reproduction by using root bulbils. So on the rhizodes of Kara aspera, some oval or spherical bulbils develop. On being detached from parent plant, bulbils germinates to form a new plant. In Kara baltica, bulbils develop on nodes of main axis. They also act as perinating organs. Third one is amorphous bulbils. In some species, there is proliferation of cells of lower nodes as irregular aggregates are called as amorphous bulbils, which also help Kara in vegetative propagation. Then fourth one is secondary protonema. These are tubular structures which develop from primary protonema, or we can say from basal cell of rhizoids. They also can form new plants. So this is, we talked about vegetative reproduction found in Kara and their cell structure. In our next lecture, we will study about sexual reproduction found in Kara. Till then, like these videos, share these videos with your friends and families, subscribe this channel, and happy learning and enjoy learning.